Hey there, my name is Josh. I'm a developer advocate here at Zeplin, and I'm about to describe two types of product teams. One of them is wasting about 10 hours per week during their handoff process, and the other gets all that time back to design, build, and ship better products. I wonder what I would do with all that free time back. And what is that difference? Well, the first team is using only Figma, and the other is using Figma and Zeplin together. I'd say this saves more than a full day a week, and I'm going to show you how. So in Figma, if you're not a designer, your experience depends entirely on how much designers have prepared that design file for you. But remember that Figma is also where designers are creating and iterating constantly. So if your team is going into the Figma file often for the handoff process, then the burden is on your designers to keep projects neat and tidy for everyone else. Like, what is this rectangle 59? I don't know what that means. When using Zeplin in your workflow, you can give your designs a really straightforward project structure and it'll be nicely organized for you already, just as you see here. And it's also set up so that you can filter by screen section or by tags or also by Jira ticket. And this takes the burden off designers and it saves some time for the team too. As a developer, or if I were a PM, I want to be able to jump in and find out what I'm looking for quickly at any point in time. And I know I can do that with Zeplin, but with Figma, it just takes some extra thinking, and even then, there's likely still some back and forth with designers for clarification. Another thing that can waste too much time is figuring out what has changed in the latest version. Figma's approach to version history is pretty basic. You can see that something's been updated, but you can't really tell what, and that again leads to more back and forth with you and your designers. Now, this is not an issue with Zeplin because there's a version history panel on each screen that tells you when new versions have been published. There's also commit messages on each version update so you can see exactly what has changed without having to chase your designers down to clue you in on what it was. When it comes to user flows, you can do it in Figma, but it's hard to figure out where the screens are flowing on a busy canvas. It gets even harder to follow as you map more journeys and try to make sense of them together, and you also can't annotate them, which most stakeholders expect to be able to do, so your flows don't really offer the full picture of that user experience, and that kind of defeats the whole purpose of having them. For flows, Zeplin is a much cleaner experience. Not only is it faster to map flows in Zeplin, but the ability to organize them into groups gives you a bird's eye view of all your user journeys, which is super important if you're working on a lot of screens. Now, how many times have you asked yourself, why doesn't the design match with what's been built? And with Figma, you'll hear this a lot because the best you can do is manually compare, and what typically happens here is that developers are squinting back and forth between each window to see if what they've built matches the actual design. This doesn't happen in Zeplin because you can simply pop it out. With pop out, you can overlay the screen from Zeplin directly on top of your build so you can quickly spot exactly what needs fixing. And that means that devs can get a pixel perfect match to the design way faster and earlier in the process. So there you have it. Those are the big differences between using Figma only versus using Figma with Zeplin. And that can add up to hours of time saved if you choose the right workflow of the two. And the team that's using Figma and Zeplin together can still enjoy Figma for the design work that it's intended for. But in addition, they can have a clean set of designs handed off through Zeplin containing exactly what your PMs, developers, and QA teams need to know without any of the other design tool distractions. You can get started for free at zeplin.io and let us know what you think. See you later.